Thank you very much, and welcome to the wonderful new Laidlaw Music Centre here in the beautiful town of St Andrews, Scotland. Wherever you are in the world today, whether you're in the hall with us, you're welcome. Whether you're somewhere very far and distant, it's great to have you with us. We're here hosted by STAMP, St Andrews University Music Participation, and we're very delighted to be here with you today. You're going to hear today all of the Whitburn Band Organisation bands. We've got four bands in total. We have a wee band, a youth band, Heartlands band, and the senior band. More about those as we go through the day. And first of all, you're going to hear, for you, they've just assembled behind me, you're going to hear a combination of the wee band and the youth band conducted by Caroline Munro. And they're going to start their program with a piece called Pirate Adventures by Gareth Bowman. And here to narrate the story, which is by Carol Doherty, is the senior band E-flat bass solo tuba player, Graham Fraser. Graham.
Thank you, Brian. Welcome to the sea of pirate adventures. From the waves, there came a mighty fin glistening in the sun. The pirate watched in silent awe and thought, this might be fun. The shark rose from the water and bared a toothy grin. The pirate, though first cautious, took a breath and dived right in. Grab on, hold tight, the shark exclaimed, splashing water in the sky. The pirate did as he was told, and in the water he did fly. The pair raced from the boat at speed and flitted on the foam. Then as the sun began to sink, the pirate said, now home. As the pirate left his newfound friend, he felt a little sad. He turned towards the shark and said, "That's the most fun I've ever had." The shark smiled again, that toothy grin, replying, "Same time next week. In fact, let's bring some friends and have a game of hide and seek." When the pirate met a shark. As the sun returned home, pink dust gave way to purple hues, settling finally into a blanket of black. A gull slowly circles overhead before calmly coming to rest on the main mast of the glorious vessel. The sky was pierced a million times, offering little glimpses of what was beyond. The ship rocked like a lullaby, soothing and maternal. She calmed her babes to rest. A calm night in the bay. Thank you. As the ship approached the destination, they could see that they were not alone. Another scavenger ship, almost as mighty as she, was approaching at the same rate from the east. The crew felt that familiar tingle of bloodlust firing their senses. The ship was a flurry with a buzz of the battle about to commence. All at once, the deck boomed with the echoes of the boots of the men who danced and weaved around one of each other with the expertise which life had afforded them. Rigging hauled, cannons loaded, swords aloft, the scurry and the noise rose to a triumphant climax as the men readied themselves for what was to come, the battle for the treasure. A glorious victory, a time for celebration. The music vibrated through every soul on board. The night sky was filled with the echoes of laughter. The captain sat at the head of the table and surveyed the scene. He felt a warm glow of satisfaction as he looked around the faces of his crew. He knew now, without doubt, they would follow him to the ends of the earth. The beat of the drum pounded. The captain began to tap his foot in time. So quiet was the tap, tap, tapping off the foot that the crew at first thought that they had imagined it. However, it soon became unmistakable as the captain turned to face them, face beaming, hands thundering together in an uproarious hammering. He jumped on top of the table demanding, "Get me my tuba!" A cheer erupted from the room as the captain danced and played in time with the thunderous drum. At once, every one of them were on their feet, the night sky alive with the beat of the techno pirate.
Thank you, Graham. Thank you, Caroline. And most of all, thank you to the Wee Band and the Youth Band. Sounds terrific, guys. Thank you very much. They have one more short piece for you. They're going to play for you the famous tune by the pop group Europe, apparently, I was just told today. It's called The Final Countdown. Over to you, guys. Thank you very much, Caroline. And behind me now, you're going to see, hopefully, an ultra-slick changeover, and we're going to allow the Wee and the Youth Bands to move to one side, and we're going to introduce you to the next level in the Whitburn Band organization, the Heartlands Band. This is a contesting band, so it's a third section band, and the idea here is to provide a pathway for the Wee players and the youth players to progress through to the Heartlands Band, and then hopefully through to the senior band in due course. The idea is that the senior band is the best band, but having heard the Heartlands Band in rehearsal just an hour ago, I'm a little bit worried about whether that will be the case or not. So we need to step up our game a little bit to get better than these guys. Are they in place yet? Oh, they are. And you'll just see walking to my side there, Mr. Stephen Duncan, who's going to conduct them. You'll notice along the way, I think, that some of the senior players not only invest their time in playing with the senior band, which is a huge commitment throughout the year, but they are also investing time and effort working with the younger bands as well, as conductors, as extra players, as percussionists, whatever you want to see there. So all the senior players are involved in the whole organization from top to bottom. So the first piece they're going to play for you now is a piece by Ray Farr, a well-known brass band player and arranger, and it's called Adventures in Brass. Whitburn Heartlands Band, for your pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stephen. As I said, many of the senior band players are involved as conductors with the junior bands and the Heartlands Band, and Stephen is himself a percussionist, timpanist today with the senior band. Not only is this a pathway for the junior players to progress to a contesting band situation, it's essentially a youth band with one or two more mature, shall we say, players helping them out. But also we do like to invite players from the Heartlands Bands and the youth bands into the senior band on occasion. And you'll notice at the back of the trombone section there is young Aileen. You'll see her also featuring in the senior band when they get their turn on the stage in a few minutes. And now we're going to play for you another arrangement by a well-known Scottish arranger, Adrian Drover, and this is of the tune Star Wars.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Star Wars there. We're going to be hearing the Heartlands Band again at the end of the concert when all four bands are going to join forces for our grand finale. But before that, their final piece in this beautiful set they've just played for us is Slavic Circus Music by Ray Woodfield.
Thank you.
you very much to the Whitburn Heartlands Band conducted by Stephen Duncan. And hopefully there'll be another ultra slick change going on behind me as we welcome the senior band onto the stage. We're going to play for you a nice little set of four pieces, and we're going to start with a number by the March King, Carl King, and it's arranged by Peter Smalley, and it's called The Melody Shop, and it's a very typical fast American march. While the band are getting set up, I should tell you that they are the current Scottish champions and the current Scottish Open champions, and have had a very successful contest season post-COVID. During COVID, you might have also been very aware that the band had a hugely high profile, got really involved in the online performances early doors. They won the Corey Band online contest and also the Five contest, and then we were lucky enough to be at the Five contest just a month ago, back in person live, and we won that again. So the band are on a very successful run, and you'll see and hear why in just a moment. I'm waffling away a little bit now until they all get ready, and I think I'll go and take up my position, and then we'll give you The Melody Shop. Thank you very much. The Melody Shop by Carl King. All hot dogs and mustard there for you. We're now going to play for you a beautiful aria from the opera Rusalka by Dvořák, written in 1900 or thereabouts. Originally for soprano singer, this is going to feature the band's very great principal cornet player, Mr. Christopher Bradley. Is it Chris or Christopher? Chris will do, apparently. So he's gone informal today. So featuring Chris Bradley, Rusalka's Song to the Moon, arranged by Gordon Langford.
Thank you.
the dulcet tones of Mr. Chris Bradley there. Thank you, Chris. We're just going to take a moment to spare a thought today for our friends in Ukraine. Terrible things going on there at the moment, still going on. And we're going to play for you a new arrangement by Stephen Roberts of a Ukrainian dance. It's called You Tricked Me, and it is originally a humorous song about a boy being let down by his girlfriend. And it's written here in the style of a Cossack, Ukrainian Cossack dance called a hopak. You Tricked Me. Thank you very much. I could see a few feet tapping in the audience. I was wondering whether somebody was going to dare to come up and do a Cossack dance. I thought about it myself for about 1 second, and I thought my knees are not up to this job, so I'll leave it today. Anyway, that was You Tricked Me, Ukrainian Cossack Dance. And for our finale today, the senior band finale at least, we're going to play for you Matthew Hall's Nightingale Dances. This is a very flamboyant sequence of dances based on the tune A Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square. We start off with a bandoneon effect with multiple flugels in the cornet section here. It's to emulate the sound of the well-known close harmony vocal group Manhattan Transfer. We then have a paso doble led by the flugelhorn with Caroline again. And we go then into a quick step. In fact, we have the quick step first, I think, then the paso doble. And we finished with a show dance, Strictly style Hollywood show dance with half time. I'm sure you know what that means if you've watched Strictly. Matthew Hall's Nightingale Dances.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Matthew Hall's Nightingale Dances to conclude our programme. The audience gave us a rapturous reception at the end there, so we've decided to play an encore. We decided anyway. And we're going to tick off something on my bucket list. I'm going to get to conduct all four Whitburn bands together. The Wee Band, the Youth Band, Whitburn Heartlands Band, and Whitburn Senior Band. So we're going to form a massive band for you all around the stage here. I'm just watching their little faces come into play. And we're going to play for you a fabulous arrangement by one of the band's players, Chris Shanks. It's, of course, of the hymn tune, Whitburn. A very appropriate ending. So I want to thank you all, those in the audience today, thank you very much for attending in person. And those at home, wherever you are, if you're as far afield as Dundee or wherever you are, thank you very much for tuning in. And please tune in to all the following events. I know there are some more, so look out on the socials. That's the right thing to say, isn't it, these days, the socials? Keep an eye on all that sort of stuff for the next stamp presentations. I can hear from the silence that we're ready to go, so thank you very much for tuning in again. Here is our grand, grand finale, the hymn tune, Whitburn.